What's up, boys? Today we're going to be looking at the Battlefield 4 Final Stand DLC. And this is kind of the prequel to Battlefield 2042. This is set right before it. It had a lot of like futuristic experimental technology. And I think some of the stuff we saw in this, we will see in Battlefield 2042. Back when this came out, I thought this kind of meant the next Battlefield game was going to be a futuristic game. And I honestly really wanted that to be the case. But we've since waited about 8 years for the next futuristic game. But we finally are getting it. So I just want to go back and look at this, talk about some of the stuff that's in the game, and talk about how you can play it. Because this is one of the sort of best ways to prepare for Battlefield 2042 if you're interested in playing something that'll be pretty similar. So the Final Stand DLC had four maps. It had Giants of Karelia, which was sort of the one non-snow map. It had Hammerhead, Operation Whiteout, and then Hangar 21. Hangar 21 is kind of a night map, and it's honestly probably my favorite of all of them, and I'm probably going to do another video talking about it because it actually has a Titan on the map, and you can do like a Levolution event that launches the Titan, or at least it like revs up the jets and the Titan. And so I'm hoping that because that was in this DLC, maybe we'll see some Titans in Battlefield 2042. But it also had the Railgun Battle Pickup, which I'm going to show the trailer of Final Stand, and you'll see the railgun towards the end of the trailer where it takes out a jet. It was super OP when it first came out. It did like 40 or 50 damage to a jet, but I'm pretty sure they nerfed it recently, or not recently, but after the DLC came out. It does like 20 damage to the air vehicles now, which is still pretty significant, but it's literally like two tapping air vehicles, which is wild. They also released a Phantom Bow, which took forever for people to figure out through the Easter egg. They released a target detector, which was actually a pretty good attachment, the stabilizer, and then they released like three different bows for the Phantom Bow. There was also the decoy gadget, and then the XD1 Accipiter, and that's sort of the flying around sort of Gatling gun that flies around in the sky, which is pretty cool. We also had the snowmobile, the hover tank, the pod launcher, and then one other vehicle, I believe. So that's kind of the gist of the DLC. Again, it's set in the sort of near future, but a bit further than most of Battlefield 4. And so it's set like in the 2020s or early 2030s, I believe. And so that's why it has a lot more experimental technology. Forgive me also, I believe some of my gameplay doesn't have audio in the background. I was gonna play this on PC, but a lot of my bindings and stuff are weird with the controller on PC because there's no real controller support for Battlefield 4. So I just decided to plug in my PS4 and play it, but getting the game audio through in some of these clips didn't happen. So forgive me for that. But most of the gameplay is just playing some engineer on these maps, and then obviously there was some sniping and tank gameplay in the intro clip as well. But yeah, I mean, that's pretty much it. Just want to talk about this DLC. If you want to play it, I'd go to your server browser. I believe this DLC is either free or it's like $5 or $10 now. And there's usually always a server running it on PC and console, and you just select the four maps that are in the DLC. So it would be Hammerhead, Giants of Karelia, Hangar 21, and Operation Whiteout. And then you can just find all the DLC-only servers that way. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video, just sort of a quick one talking about Final Stand DLC and how it's pretty much the prequel to 2042. So if you want to play something that's going to be the most similar to the new game, this is where you're going to find it. But that's about it for this video, guys. I'll probably leave you with a bit of the gameplay in the background to end it off, but I'll see you guys next time.